right, guys, we are here at Maple Grove Raceway in Monton, Pennsylvania, right next to Reading. Place has a special place in my heart. It's a beautiful racetrack. The Koretsky family has been awesome over the years to deal with, and we're out here racing with them this weekend. Got the warden out here. My son is making headway.
Hey guys, it's Jimmy Howe from Howe Motorsports here. We're at Maple Grove Raceway this weekend. I'm excited to show you guys the warden. It's right behind me here. It's a 521 Brad Anderson Hemi with a Troy Christensen blower on it. It makes about 3,400 horsepower to the wheels, something like that. It's got a Extreme Automatics Turbo 400 in it, and this is my car. I'm gonna be running futures in it this year. The current plan is right now is to build me a new NPK car this winter, and to come out here and dominate next year. I made my first pass on the racetrack when I was 8 years old in a little Honda back when my family owned the I-40 dragway. So I've been racing pretty much my whole life.
My name is Tony McKinney and I drive Novocaine. So we're here at NPK at Maple Grove, and I got to pop Jimmy Howe's cherry in NPK for the very first time. He always talks a lot of shit. So, you know, I told him one day he's gonna call me daddy. Listen, he's a good kid, I'm proud of him, I'm glad he gets this opportunity. But I still busted his ass, so I'm happy with that.
What's up guys, Scott Taylor here. You're probably wondering what the heck I'm doing on Jim Howe's channel, but what we're doing is a little grudge race. We're not in the quick eight this week, so we figured we was gonna do a little something, have some fun, and maybe win some fuel money. Well, I posted up that I wanted Justin Swanstrom off the trailer, and he declined. He had good reason. He had had a wreck here last year, so we moved that to second round for a grudge. Well, the way I see it, that left me another pass that I could grudge somebody else and have some more fun, and Jim Howe took the call out. He said, I'll race you first round. So he stepped up and said, I'll race you off the trailer.
I'm back, Dan Newsbaum, crew chief of Team Dumb Shit. Haven't had any problems today, but I'm with the Gaurdian again, and we got the oil lines and everything fixed from last weekend. We got new wheels on the front of it. Just went out and did a grudge race with Scott Taylor, and we won. So now we all get treated with ice cream. You know, we're gonna go out, have some ice cream, you know, strawberry, chocolate, vanilla, who knows? It might be a swirl, yeah, I don't know. You know, but eat some ice cream. And it did great, ran real good and all that kind of stuff. Track's a little iffy up there. It's got quite a good bit of rubber on it still. They did a NHRA race here last weekend, so there's a lot of rubber down. And it was a little tricky, but we went out, rocked and rolled, got it right down there and all that kind of stuff, made it a super good pass, came back, pulled the valve train apart, checked everything out, did our normal stuff, and everything's good to go. So it's on to tomorrow, and hopefully kick some butt and go some rounds tomorrow.
We have been very busy all weekend, so this recap is just going to be the entire recap for the weekend. I want you guys to ride along with me, if you will. So Friday night, we come off the trailer, made a good rip in testing and tuning. It was so good that I decided to park the car. Like, no sense in beating on parts. It was awesome. John's car, same thing. It was great. Came out first round today for chip draw. We drew Kai Kelly, which is a bear. Now, for me, that's kind of a good thing, because last year, whenever we got our momentum, we drew Kai Kelly, and I was able to take him out first round. We drew Ryan, I was able to take him out first round, so on and so forth. So we finally had some momentum going up, and today we drew Kai. So I was like, man, maybe today's the day we're finally going to do some good. Kai red lighted first round, and we went on to second round. Second round, I drew Lizzie Musi. It was a dog fight all day today with everybody we drew, but drawing Lizzie is no slouch ever. Third round, I got Rich Bruder. Bruder broke on the starting line. He'd had some problems, and I got to make a single, so I just idled it down the racetrack, conserved parts. Back to back to back right now. Parts attrition is everything. So we don't want to put a bunch of abuse on the car if we don't have to. So I idled it down the racetrack. We already had good data out of that lane. There was no sense in beating on the equipment for no reason. The next round, we drew Daddy Dave. I was able to beat Daddy Dave, and you know, that's I think second time this year that I've been able to get around Daddy Dave. So the deal is that stuff catches up eventually. You can't always beat everybody every time. Sooner or later, they're going to outrun you. That set me up for the final round with no other than Ryan Martin. And it's a cool story because Ryan and I talked on the phone this week, and I said, man, look, we both had monkeys on our back all year. We both crashed our cars. We struggled all year. I said, it's time for us to put these two cars in the finals. And I reminded him of that after the semifinal win with Daddy Dave and whenever he beat Nate Saylor. So here we go, you know, got Ryan Martin in the final and me in the final. And that is a absolute awesome deal for us. I couldn't have asked for a better weekend. Starting line for final round. Ryan leaves a little early. He didn't guess. I want to make sure everybody understands how this works. The tree was really, really long. Ryan actually double pumped the button, but he went green. So, like, hey man, hats off to those guys. There's no shame in any of that. Like, and I don't want to take anything away from him. He got out of the car and told me what had happened. He was a true gentleman, a true sportsman, just like I know he is. You know, I got out of the car and was like, dude, you drilled my eyes out on the tree. I don't know how you left like that. And he was like, look, man, I got no lies to tell. He said, you know, the tree was so long. He said, I come off the button. I just knew I was going red. And, you know, he must have caught it as it was coming on. So he went green. And, you know, man, like, no big deal. He thought I'd be upset. And I was not upset. I'm not upset at all. We just took a car that we totaled a few months ago and put it in an invitational final round against the best of the best. And we drew the best of the best all year long, or all day long. So I'm happy. John's car made a lot of headway. We just got out horsepowered against Nate Saylor, and we've been working on John's car, and we'll continue to work on it. I've got some stuff that we're going to do this week. I'm going to change the motor in it, and we're going to go to Martin, Michigan, and try something new. If we leave them the same, we're going to get the same results. So we have to work on them. We have to push harder, and I'm going to put something together for John this week that hopefully will turn his around. But, guys, that's it. I appreciate you riding along with me. Like, subscribe, comment. I love hearing from you.